We didn't know about this, guys. We thought we was about to blow up our basement because we so scared. All the time, we're scared of blowing up our basement. Here comes the rain again. That's the dilemma. So we gotta wash the meat still, right? To process it, because we haven't done that part yet. I mean, we did pre-do stuff, but like we need to wash it and separate it and then bring, we could bring it inside here and process it further, but it's raining outside. That's one of those delicious inside of the rib cage pieces of meat. Ah! This water is so cold. Yeah, guys, this is a total blessing for our family and for our refrigerator right now. And we're gonna make sure that we use every bit of this that we can use. Even though we're learning, we're going to try to be very, very particular about how we process this thing so that we can make sure that we are getting the most out of it. Yeah? This is just, I don't know what this is yet. It looks like we're gonna process that stuff though. And because we're not willing to, first of all, guys, we don't have a place to do this. We don't have big refrigerators. We don't even have a house. So these, we've been aging this in our cooler. So, which we learned on YouTube, right? So, and it works really well, but we can't like leave it forever. So even though it's raining, guys, it doesn't mean we can stop. We have to keep going and process this thing so we don't let any of this deer go to waste, right? Rain or shine, guys, we got to show up. You know what I mean? That's a big old heart right there, guys. Patang, 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 patang. Brought it back to life, guys. Told you I've been watching Dr. House. You know what I mean? Don't die on me now, Bambi! No, just kidding. This is a good way to make sure that you know your deer was healthy too. You know, you want to get a good visual on all the major organs and stuff. You're looking for funny spots or funny growths or anything like that. This deer was a very healthy deer.
What are you going to do with the heart?
It's going to become dog food. Or catfish food, one of the two, if you know what I mean. But it's probably going to be dog food. I'm not going to eat the heart. I know that some people do, but I don't know. We can look at it and see what. I just don't think I like heart. I don't, for some reason, I just don't think that it's my cup of tea for some reason. You know what I mean? What's up, baby cakes?
Getting ready to go down.
Okay.
Just wanted to check on you.
Yep. I'm good. I'm gonna start harvesting those deers here. Ready? Right here. Look at this. Ready? Right there. It's gonna follow a fat line. There's a fat line right there. You know what I mean? Once I find it, then I'll pull it apart. I'll find those segments just like that. One at a time, man. You know what I mean?
I'm back.
Yeah, all right.
Is that the same one you were working on when I left?
No. Just getting some of the worst of the worst off here. This is like a bunch of belly meat.
You think that's where the gland is?
I don't know. I'm just going to do like I've been doing and pull out all the fat. Because I don't like any of the deer fat anyways. Right?
Right. It's getting it out there.
It's getting it. Helped some. Our pond was below the branches just about all the way.
So after many days of working on the deer, we are finally done with breaking it down and getting it packaged up. It is cold out here, you guys. Sorry, I'm shivering. But we are out here in the basement. Got the stove out and we got the chickens processed. So check it out. Marcel's gonna make us some bone broth. Got some chicken feet in there, carcasses. It's looking good.
You know what that is, baby cakes? You know what that is.
Bone broth.
That's bone broth, guys. We're like almost real homesteader status right now. You know what? It smells delicious.
Mm-hmm.
So this thing's gonna be bubbling all night long. It's been bubbling since 1 o'clock. I lit it up at 1 o'clock today. Not sure what time it is now. Probably getting close to 7. So 6 hours it's been gone. 24 hours, they say.
Smells so good.
It was up to here, though. It's bubbled down that far already. All right, guys. Tonight, it's freezing. Drops into the high 20s. I think it's like 27 tonight.
Yeah.
28. So since the freezing temperatures are going to last like 7 hours, guys, we're going to shut our water off. We're still running our water off of the garden hose plumbing, guys, which is working out pretty good when the temperatures aren't freezing and when my hoses aren't exploding. You know what I mean? Yeah, so guys, we're going to have to make like a mad dash to get all of our water needs taken care of so that I can be in bed at a respectable hour. You know what I mean? If the goats are coming out, I already want to be asleep. You know what I'm saying?
Besides, it's cold in there.
It's cold, yeah, guys, it's cold. So we're going to get our water needs done. We're going to start
to get everything buckled down. And...
yeah, we need to remind ourselves what this means because we'll be doing it on a regular basis this winter. We actually have 3 nights like this, so... we'll have a good crash course on what it means to be winter again.
Yeah.
And then it warms up.
Preparation in between times, like unhooking hoses and draining them and stuff. So.
Yeah, it's good times, guys. We shut the pump off.
Yep, we get to do that tonight, so.
Yay.
All right, let's go get everything taken care of.
All right. This is what it means to get your water needs taken care of, guys. You gotta Drain the Berkey so that you got extra fresh water already made. Fill the Berkey up the rest of the way, because this is going to be coffee in the morning, guys. Filtered straight out of the ground, guys, 600 feet down. Then we bring it up 600 feet and then another 500 feet up the mountain into our camper, where then we filter it through our shiny Berkey.
And now I can just let this drain down here then.
Oh yeah, see, watch. See how that's supposed to turn? This one ain't gonna come off, I don't think. See what I mean? It's stuck on here. This sucker for 18 hours. That's right. 18 hours. Let's just see. Oh my goodness, there's just so much stuff in here, baby cakes.
Smells so good. Mm-hmm. Are you a good little boy? Just sitting so pretty. Mm-hmm.
It's been kind of rough on everybody the last few days with the rain going on. The dogs were really good and played quietly in their little corner together. They did well with being cooped up, but they're ready to be outside and running around and smelling the good food, wanting to eat it. And this little guy.
What little guy? They can't see him, baby cakes.
I just showed him.
Oh. All right, here we go. We made this, guys. We made this. And these are our chickens, too.
Alright everybody, so we've been boiling some chicken bone broth for how many hours, babe?
18 hours, baby cakes. 18 hours.
And we are getting ready to jar it up for canning.
Give me my scoopy doopy right there. Behind your poopy. Yeah, right about there.
1 inch head space.
Okay, baby cakes, let's get the lid of that wiped. I'll grab another jar. This is a first, man. But there's supposed to be some medicinal properties to this bone broth. And if you guys have been following along for a while, you'd be knowing I got problems with my shoulders, man. It's the joints, you know what I'm saying? Some people call it arthritis. I don't know anything about none of that. All I know is I'm going to try some bone broth.
Heck yeah.
It's supposed to help my bones.
Yeah. So we got this it's actually a Miromatic pressure canner. We picked it up at the thrift store for $10, you guys.
$9.99, baby.
Mm-hmm. All the parts. The gasket's even in good condition. So I didn't order one yet. But we're going to go ahead and get this thing going.
Put the lid on it. It's on, baby. Mm-hmm. Turn it up to medium-high heat.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So medium to high heat could be different on this.
Right.
So we'll have to, once it starts to vent steam, we'll see how much steam. If it's going like it's break time at the refinery, then we'll probably turn it down before we put the weight on it. You know what I mean? I'm just going to tell you guys, I would feel more comfortable if we had the gauge on there. You know what I mean? Some of them come with that little, and then you can see what the gauge is. You know what I mean? But I do believe this is like a pressure relief valve, so this thing doesn't blow up. That's our biggest concern, guys. We're so scared because we've seen a meme on Facebook, you know. There is instances where these things can blow up, but I do believe most of the time you really got to be trying to make these things malfunction like that. Otherwise, a rubber gasket will fail before the metal will fail. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So, but don't quote me on that, guys, because I'm not a rubber seal specialist or a metal specialist. You know, maybe some of the old metal, you know, like Metallica. Yeah!
So we don't have a whole lot of experience with pressure canners. I do use a pressure cooker quite often, so yeah. We're not like novices to it. We do know how to use them.
Novice.
We're not novices to them. We do know how to use it a little bit.
Yeah.
My ninja. Yeah.
It's the ninja guy. So we have been pressure cooking for quite some time. We actually got another one of these stowed away somewhere that we still haven't even taken out of the box. I know Baby Cakes thinks that we bailed on it.
I don't think that we have
one. We bought one, guys. It's brand spankety new. And we're going to find it when we undo our shipping container. There's going to be one, because I was like, well, maybe we could pressure cook in that instead, because we weren't ready to pressure can. But we bought all this stuff, guys, before we came out here to the country, right? And we got as far as learning how to water bath can.
Yeah, we've done quite a bit of that.
Yeah, we made jellies. And we canned peaches, and we canned the things that you can can in a water bath,
mm-hmm.
right? But we've never done this.
So my favorite was the apple butter, you guys. We picked up some apples from
we were so
Palisade.
Country.
Oh, man.
We made our own apple butter. We were like homesteading in the city, like, well.
Kind of, yeah. We were trying to do it in the city, but it was tough, you guys. Yeah.
We did what we could, though.
Yeah.
Our neighbors had goats, so we was in the farm anyways.
Mm-hmm. They were cute, too.
Yeah. All right, guys. So this is going to be a slow and go. We have, what do we got, Baby Cakes? We got a little bit of this bone broth left.
We do. We should test it.
So we didn't add any salt to this bone broth. Zero. Zilcho. Because part of being healthy for me is going to mean that I need to tone down the salt a little bit too, guys. You know, because it's not good for pressure, man, unless you want lots of it. We're going to have us a bone broth drink, guys, for lunch.
It'll be nice because we both kind of woke up not feeling at our tip-top shape.
Yeah,
so.
Or even halfway. I'm bad. I'm in bad shape, guys. I was up all night with headaches and it's that time of year, I think.
Yeah, the weather change is definitely messing with us. So we're going to go ahead and give it a try. Yeah. We're going to go ahead and give this bone broth. So we're gonna give the bone broth a try and see if it, I don't know, helps out a little bit.
It can't hurt baby cakes, because here's what it is. I'm gonna tell you how it's going to improve my health immediately. Mm. I don't have to drive to the store.
Yeah.
I don't have to pay the high price mm-hmm. of bone broth. Now, I didn't even know there was a difference, guys. There's
chicken
like stock and soup and bone broth and broth. Something's just called broth. I don't even know, guys. There's too many categories, but with each of them, they come with another new, very surprising price. You know what I mean? Especially something as, I'm not gonna say, I don't wanna say organic, but this stuff here is definitely going to be high quality. You know what I mean? Because we took very good care of our chickens. If you had to buy this stuff, guys, for the price that it cost us to raise those chickens, it would be like $700 a quart. That's all I'm saying.
We're really looking forward to it. It smells so good.
I tasted it, guys.
Did you?
I did.
Is it good?
It is. It's very good.
Nice.
It's not salty. So I expect, I have a standard, right? But then I reminded myself that what I do is take a salty substance and then I add my salt to it. No salt, guys. No salt.
Yeah, that's not good.
And it had just a little bit of zing-a-ling-ling in there, guys, because I put some red pepper seeds in it. Oh, man. You want to tell them what we put in there, baby guys?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, guys, so we put some bay leaf. First of all, we put all the chicken giblets and the feet.
Yep.
And the carcasses that were left, right, from our harvest. Mm-hmm. 7 birds, right? So we have all that stuff in there. And there was a bunch of meat left because we didn't harvest their wings because there was very little meat, right? All we did was harvest their the breasts and the tenders and the thighs and leg. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So the rest of that went in here, and then we put some bay leaf in there, guys. Bang! Bay leaf. I love bay leaf, man. Brings back
peppercorns.
Such a, peppercorns, man. I got some allspice in there, guys. We got some rosemary. Yeah. Some rosemary in there. We got like 3 whole bulbs of garlic.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We got whatever carrots we have left. Yep.
Celery.
And a bunch of celery. So that's like the base flavor. So we have 0 salt. This don't seem right because it ain't coming out nowhere else. I still don't know that anything is really wrong. It could be something's wet in here too. It was steaming off, but I ain't willing to take a chance. What I'm gonna do is, once we can take that off, I'm gonna inspect it. And we'll look for visible damage, because now we know it was leaking from this side, steam, something over here. So hopefully it's just the gasket, because we can get the gasket for fairly inexpensive, right?
Yeah.
But for now, guys, we're not messing around. Baby Cakes is right. We put all kinds of time and effort into this bone broth to fix my bones. You know what I mean? So we're gonna boogie over there to Walmart, and hopefully they got one.
So are we running to the store, or you think we should try it again?
I think we should try it again, because... Come on, guys. There's a little pressure valve right there. Right? We didn't know about this, guys. We thought we was about to blow up our basement, because we so scared. All the time, we're scared of blowing up our basement with our pressure cooker. You know what I'm saying? So here we are, we found it. We found the leak, guys. It's right there. So if you know anything about pressure canning, you already know more than me. We're gonna put it back on, guys. Let me make sure that, see, like there's a little notch in here on both sides, so you almost can't do it wrong.
You sure?
Yeah, look. Look, you're in here, so this will not be like, it's not coming off DC. It's on. and too high. That's pretty close to as gently, continuously as you're gonna get. The other way was good too. What? Well, pressure cannon. Bam! Come on! That's an air conditioned cover for RV, guys. He's got it on there like a hood scoop. He must be bombing the country.
Homesteading it.
Yeah. I don't think that's redneck. I think that's